I felt it really had to start as a journey of sort of self-insight, finding out who I was and who I wanted the world to see me as.
Living life with no filter is living a life that you're meant to live, kind of creating your own destiny.
While I was living with that filter, not being honest to myself, but also not being honest to the people around me, I was probably not even half the person I am today.
So living life with no filter means that not only can I be myself, but my partner and I can be a family.
I try my hardest to be present at every single moment and listen to my feelings, listen to my instincts, and listen to my moral compass.
But now all of a sudden I can think to myself, I'm happy to be me.
I'm a minority within a minority. People will like you if you're just being honest and being authentic.
The biggest influence on my life was me.
This is where it begins to start being okay. You know, I had a lot of bridges to build. I had a lot of wrongs to right. And it was only when I found that I could be accepted by other people and I learned to accept myself.
I wasn't talking to my friends, my family, my employer about who I am, what I want to be, and how I want to live my life.
Society had applied this filter. They told me what gender normal was. Take that time to really understand who you are. Don't rush into sort of releasing your filter and allowing people to see the real you until you're really confident with who that real you is.
We mustn't lose sight of the roots of pride in being about overcoming shame. Pride isn't just for gay people, isn't just for LGBT community, it's for everybody. It's a chance for everybody to show their themselves as they are, to show their solidarity with the LGBT community. It's a fantastic way to engage with colleagues, with clients, to continue the work of supporting LGBT people in every part of their lives.
Pride of London has so much more to give than just the people of London. People come from all over and they look and they think, wow, what an amazing way that next year I could potentially be like that. If I can make a stance, if I can find some strength just from this moment right now, then next year I could be a part of that play, being who I want to be and celebrating it.
Because I own the fact that I'm transgender, nobody can use that as a weapon against me. Pride for me is not just about the people that identify as LGBT celebrating their diversity.
The balance has tipped, become more about celebration and more about what we can do to be a beacon of hope to other places around the country, around the world, which haven't made the same sort of changes that we have.